Yo, I'm Kola, and today I'm gonna show you how to use Ableton Live Lite, Ableton's entry-level DAW. I'm gonna show you how to set it up so you can start making music today. Let's get it. So, where can you get Ableton Live Lite? Where is it? Is it here? Under this? No. You can get it in different software and hardware bundles. And you can get it with Lander, which includes mastering, samples, plugins, distribution, and courses. Make sure to check the link in the description below so you can find it there. Boom. So the first time you open up Ableton, it's gonna look like this. And I know you wanna start making beats right away, but stop! First thing you have to do is open up the settings and set up your audio interface. This is what you'll be using to record into Ableton and listen to your playback. I'll be using the mini fuse. So I'm gonna set the input as mini fuse and the output as mini fuse, like so. And if you're gonna be using your laptop microphone and speakers, then you can find them in this list too. So another thing you have to take care of if you're gonna be using third-party plugins is you wanna make sure your VST system folders are enabled. This is it. Make sure that these are on. Very important, this is on. VST stands for virtual instrument, which is basically like an instrument in your computer, like a piano or a bass or a tuba, you know, something like that. Very important, just remember that if you install any new plugins, make sure to click this rescan button and Live is gonna find all the plugins and put them in the plugin list for you. So before we get started, Ableton has a helpful info box down here in the corner, and whatever you hover your little mouse over, it's gonna tell you what it does. So Ableton has two views. There's session view and arrangement view, which you can switch between by pressing tab or clicking up here. Arrangement view is similar to what you've seen in other DAWs, but session view is unique to Live. It's mainly made for live performance, but it's great to sketch out new ideas. Let me show you what I mean. Each rectangle is called a clip, and you'll find multiple clips per track. Clips are like containers that hold musical ideas like a bass line or a drum pattern. Each row here is called a scene, and you can launch every clip in a row by pressing the play button corresponding to that row on the right. And when those start playing together, you get music. Okay, so you see we have two MIDI tracks and two audio tracks here. I'm gonna be using MIDI, so I'm gonna delete these two audio tracks. So MIDI stands for Musical Instrument Digital Interface, basically means you're sending messages to trigger an instrument. So to get started with MIDI, just double click this empty clip and you'll see the piano roll pop up with one bar. And I'm gonna enable the metronome here and press play on the clip and you'll see four beats go by. Amazing. So you can always make this clip longer by clicking and dragging over here. And now I have four bars, or you can click and type in something like eight bars. A dope function that's unique to Live 12 is the scale function, which allows you to set the scale for your session. Up here, you have a range of all the scales, and the one that you select, I'm gonna go with C major. And if you come down here and press highlight scale, you'll see all the notes in the scale highlighted. And if you press scale, now that collapses them and you only see the notes in the scale. This is helpful if you're not a music nerd and you don't know music theory and you want to get started making music fast. So to input notes into the piano roll, you can double click anywhere over here, or you can press B and you can draw it in like this. So here I have a bass line, it's one bar, and I set my grid to 16th notes over here because I want that syncopated feel. But when I press play, nothing. So that's where Live's instruments come in. Over here in instruments, Live has five instruments: drift, drum rack, impulse, instrument rack, and simpler. And they each have a bunch of presets. So I'm gonna go over here in drift and find a bass sound, body bass, double click that. You want to press play? Beats. Let's go. So now it's time for drums. I'm going to go over here to a drum rack and choose a preset. 909 core kit sounds good. Double click that. And I'm going to create a clip. And as you can see, all the sounds are neatly laid out over here on the side. So I'm gonna draw in a kick drum, also known as a bass drum. If I drag this section here, I can duplicate it using Command D four times, magic. Let's hear what that sounds like. Actually, I have to press play here. Now we got a kick. Let's go. I'm gonna add in a snare. Now we need a hi-hat. Let's go. Duplicate. Vibes. My cameraman is bouncing. And if that was too much for you, just head over to Clips and you can drag in some pre-made drum beats just to get you started even quicker. This is a banger. All right, so let's map this out using the scenes. I'm gonna have no drums in the first scene and then I'll have the drums come in with the bass in the second scene. So I'm gonna drag my drums down here to the second scene and then option drag my bass to copy it down over here. And when I press play on the scene here, bring the drums in. So now that I have an idea with two tracks, I want to get into arrangement view. There's a few different ways I can do this. I'm going to record it in. So I'm just going to press record. And you can let this bass line loop as long as you want until you're ready for the next element to come in. So now I'm gonna go over to the arrangement view and I'm gonna press this orange button here to tell Live that I'm ready to use the arrangement view. Boom. Another way you can do this is just to copy paste. So I'm gonna select this clip here, press shift to select the other one too. Command C to copy, go over to the arrangement view, click anywhere, press Command V, and there it is, magic. You can also click the whole scene, drag the whole scene into the arrangement view like this. In Ableton, you can find samples on the left that you can drag into the audio tracks. So I'm gonna navigate to samples here. And let's say I want a little pad underneath this beat. I'm gonna filter by pad, click here, and choose ambient swells. Drag it in. There it is. Live Lite comes with a few samples, but you can also use Lander Samples plugin to access a huge library of sounds that you can just drag and drop. So I'm just going to open up Lander Samples, and I'm thinking I want maybe some vocals on this track. So I'm gonna go into search, and I'm gonna see what I can find. That's dope. That's sick. I like this sound right here. I'm going to go up here and change my key to E minor to match my track. And just drag in the sample to my session here, like this. Press play. Vocals. I turn this up a bit. Dude, that's dope. Nice. So, we talked about the different track types. Now it's time to record. In Ableton, you can record both audio and MIDI. And to do so, all you have to do is click over here to the arm record button and then press record. We'll be right back. And if you want a bit of count in to give yourself time to prepare, press this button over here and you'll have 4 beats. So if you want to loop a specific section and record multiple takes that you can choose from later, just select the section you want and hit Command L and press record. Funky, like a monkey. Funky, like a donkey. That's a hit. Okay, now if I right click the track and select show take lanes, I'll see all the audio I recorded, and using the pencil tool, I can select the part that I want. Funky, like a donkey. Funky, like a donkey. This is known as comping. Everything I just did with audio, you can do with MIDI as well. By recording with MIDI, you can get a more natural performance. I'm using a MIDI keyboard, but if you don't have one, you can also use your computer keyboard by clicking up here and doing this. Masterpiece. So I have the loop brace set. Let's record some MIDI. And you'll see I can comp my MIDI performances as well. Funky,
like a donkey. Funky, like a donkey. Amazing.
Yay! Get down!
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 One of the most powerful parts of live is that you can warp and transform everything. For example, I'm gonna go into this MIDI clip I just recorded, and I like the performance, but I want the notes to line up a bit better with the track. So I played a 16th note groove, so I'm gonna click over here and select 16th notes, and I'll blend in the quantization a little bit, but not too much, because you wanna keep it human, you know, not robotic. Let's hear what that sounds like.
Funky, like a donkey. Funky.
Donkey music. All right, so let's go in the opposite direction. Let's say I wanna add a human feel to something I already drew in. So I already drew in these drums. Let's go over here. Now let's head over to the pitch and time tab and select 14%. Click humanize, and you see the MIDI move just slightly. Every time you click it, it gives you a new performance. Let's see what that sounds like.
Funky, like a donkey. Funky.
Natural donkeys.
Like a monkey.
Amazing. In Live Lite, you get access to 16 different effects that you can use to affect the audio playing through each track. I really like delay, and I like reverb, so I'm gonna drag those in and you can see them pop up at the bottom of the screen, and you can even change the order of them like this. Let's see what that sounds like. Now let's get into mixing. Mixing means making sure your track sounds the way you want it to and getting it ready for mastering. This means adjusting volumes and using effects like I just showed you. Ayo, it's a lot to get into, I get it. If you're looking for more tutorials on mixing, you'll find them on this channel, or you can head over to Lander where you'll find 150 different courses on everything from mixing to production. Perfetto. In Live, you can adjust the volume of each track in a few different places, either on the side of the track in arrangement view like this, or if you pop over to the session view and move the faders like this. If you want the mixer in arrangement view, just go over to view mixer and you'll see the mixer show up in arrangement view like so. Along with the volume fader, I also have the pan knob that I can use to move the signal from left to right, like this. I also have the send knobs that I can use to send the signal all the way over here to the return tracks that have reverb and delay on them. So up and down like this. So actually what I can do is I can go over to my vocal and I'll delete the reverb and delay that I have on here and just send it over using the send knobs like this. And what's cool is that I can send more than one sound to the same return. So I'll send my drums to the delay. Please use this sparingly, or not, up to you. Another thing you need to know about when you're mixing is automation. This means changing any parameter over time. In order to enable automation mode, just press A. You'll see these little red lines pop up. Then over here on this dialog box, you can select which parameter you want to automate. I'm gonna go with reverb. What's really convenient in live is that you can automate literally anything by right clicking and selecting show automation. So for example, if I want my drums to come up in volume, I can right click the fader here, select show automation. And if I click there and there, drag this down. Magic. And if you want to automate multiple parameters on the same track, just click the plus here and you'll be able to see multiple automation lanes. And now
it's time to explore the track.
Okay. Now it's time to export this banger. To do this, I'm gonna select the part of the track that I wanna export. I'll go over to File, Export Audio. You can see the render length is already set. And you can export either WAV or MP3 by clicking these buttons here. I'm gonna click MP3 and WAV and export. And that's it. Now I'm gonna go take a nap on my couch. Yo, thanks for watching this video. If you have any questions about Ableton Live Lite, just leave them in the comments below, and I'll catch you in the next one. Kola out. Peace.